Hello, Virgo. Thank you very much for tuning into my channel. I just want to thank all my new subscribers and the beautiful comments I've received. You have no idea how much that means to me. And if you are new, please hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all of my new videos I post. And yeah, so Virgo, this is your reading for November 2019. We will be looking at your current energy, possibly some of your past, and then what's, you know, coming towards you. So this will not resonate with every Virgo, but please let me know if it does resonate with you. I would love to hear that. So what I do is I pre-shuffle these and, you know, do my shuffle thing and they fall out. And then I sit here and kind of meditate and pick up, you know, what energy I'm getting, so you don't have to sit here and watch me do that. But I'll also shuffle some cards from other decks for clarification and confirmation. So what I'm seeing here, Virgo, is, you know, this is kind of like your reading for October. It's almost like no movement has happened yet, but this could be an entirely different situation as well. So first thing I saw was the abundance card, okay? And that's the Hunter Moon, so it's like the fall card. And it's like you have abundance staring you in the face, okay? This could be possibly someone you're already with, okay? A new person, a new love, a new friend, somebody at work, okay? That you're just not looking at in that way. Okay, because I feel like you're also in a period of like clouded thoughts, okay? And then we have the Fear card as well. So it's like this goes hand in hand. It's like you're battling between your fear-based thoughts up here, like your ego, and your soul and your heart-based thoughts. So you're kind of confused between the two. And it's kind of blocking you from seeing what's right in front of you, okay? I feel like there is something in your life or something that you're not seeing that is literally right in front of you, okay? That's being overlooked. And I just feel like you're kind of, or this could be your past, and the roles could be reversed. But the Creation card is in reverse as well, so it's like your creativity is blocked. You're unable to step forward to create and manifest your true desires. Maybe you're stuck in your old ways, your old way of thinking, afraid of the unknown, afraid to try something new, okay? Whatever that may be for you. Like I said, it could be a new person. You know, maybe you're not looking at them that way, but if you kind of put your foot out and gave them a chance or something like that, that it would be incredible for you and you just don't know, or a new opportunity for a job or a new home or something just kind of holding you back. You're trying to figure out what it is you truly want. But then it's like, I feel like you're about to come into your power, okay? Your own power, and like a powerful connection is on its way. Something powerful, I feel like, is standing right in front of you, but you can't see it yet, if that makes any sense. And then we have the darkness reversed. So that means it's like you're coming into your power, you're moving out of the darkness and into the light, okay? You're getting out of this clouded thought process, okay? And moving into the light, because right before the Power card, we got the Action card. So I feel like somebody's about to take action, okay? And you're about to come into your own power. So I don't know if maybe once you come into your own power, you're going to decide to give somebody another chance, or you're going to give a stranger a chance, or, you know, maybe someone you overlooked, a situation you overlooked. I feel like, you know, you're about to give that a chance, or the universe is going to throw it in your face and hope that you accept the offer, okay? To try something different, to go out of your norm, to try something new, okay? And then the, you know, the Wisdom being reversed as well. It's like you're not in touch with your true self. You're not listening to your inner wisdom. it could have been possibly you were hurt in the past, and if this is someone that hurt you in the past, you're not willing to see any good coming from them. But the good might be staring you right in the face, okay? It's like you're, this card tells me with the Wisdom being in reverse, it's time to take what you need from the past and then leave it behind, okay? So it's time to do something new, try something new. And if it is someone from your past that has hurt you and they want a second chance, I feel like that's still trying something new. Your old way of thinking would be like, no way, I'm not, no. It's just going to happen again, okay? But you'll never know if you don't try. Because whatever that situation is for you, it says here, you know, there's abundance staring you in the face. There's something in your life you're not seeing clearly because you have clouded judgment here. And I feel like you're about to come into your power if you're not already feeling that way. And then the Faith card. The Faith card has several meanings. You could have a deep faith, connection to spirit, God, you know, whatever you believe in. Or you're beginning to have faith in yourself and the universe, bringing yourself to a higher level of self-love so that you can attract what your heart deeply desires. It's like when you start to just have faith in the universe and you take those chances and be like, oh, the universe will guide me through this. Okay, listen to yourself. If you're feeling a nudge to do something out of your norm, try it. Okay? It's better than sitting in a place of darkness and where you can't create something new. Like you're sitting here and not making a move because you're trying to think it over, or you're just too stuck in your old way of living. Okay? And I feel like you need to put your foot out there just a little bit. Just put yourself out there a little bit. And, you know, going back to, if this is, you know, similar to your reading in October, if you were the person that it resonated with, it's like you're still at a standstill, right? You know, maybe like I had mentioned, a person, you're not sure if that person feels the same way about you. And it's like, they do. There's abundance staring you in the face, but you're too unsure to make a move, right? But I feel like you're about to come into your power. And that action will be taken. Oh, wow. Nope. I didn't shuffle those yet. So, I'm sorry. Some kind of action. Yeah. Because we have the action card. And it's like you, because, like I said, you coming into your power. Look at that. I mean, look at that person, that woman coming into her power. And that's the action card. It's like you realizing you are powerful, you deserve love, you know, and you don't have to hide yourself. I feel like that's kind of what's going on. Like, because of your fear, you're hiding yourself. Yes. The dragonfly magic. I embrace my transformation. I courageously let go of the past. Yes. The magic of nature is in me. I am brilliant and I am blessed. Yeah. Actually, you know what? I totally forgot. I was going to pull from, so we'll just set that one right there. I usually do the spirit cards, the spirit animal cards closer to the end. So I was going to do the energy oracle just to maybe get some more confirmation or insight into the situation. Maybe look at what exactly is coming towards you. Spirit, what else is coming towards Virgo, or what other advice do you have? Okay, so we got two. Okay, you know what? This one actually came out, I think it was another earth sign reading. But it's your heart chakra, Virgo. Okay, so once again, we're just telling you, you need to move towards what your heart desires. Your heart always knows what it truly wants, okay? So once you get rid of this clouded judgment and tune into your heart and what it really wants and start taking those chances, you'll be able to see what it is that's standing right in front of your face. Because it's like, yeah, because there's clouds covering her eyes in that picture. You're not seeing what's literally right in front of you, okay? And this could lead you, this is the second one that came out, to to a happy family, possibly, if you're looking for marriage or some kind of deeper relationship. But a happy family could also indicate just a new job or something where you have good connections with people, you feel comfortable there, okay? But yeah, it's definitely indicating that's what you could have if you just, you know, put your foot out there a little bit and listen to your heart and let your heart be the guide here. What else, Spirit? What else for Virgo? Ooh. Well, we got quite a few, so we'll just, we'll see. Okay, so the first chakra reversed, okay? That could very well just go hand in hand with how you're currently feeling or what was in your recent past. You're not feeling stable about yourself. You're not feeling stable, secure with yourself. I feel like there's a lot of insecurities going on here, okay? Because you're not in touch with your true self. And that's how you're feeling, or you were feeling, but it's like you're coming into your true power, learning to love yourself. I think I said that earlier. Listening to your heart and what is actually true. The garden and the gate. So, yeah, I mean, that's basically what I was saying. It's like she's sitting in the comfort of this garden, right? But it's like she has the key on her neck. She has everything she needs to put open that garden gate to something new. And this abundance is somewhere in your life already, okay? It's just you need to open your mind to it, your heart to it, and open that gate, right? Open that gate to it. You have the key within you to do this. Your heart is aligned. You just have to tune in. You just have to listen to it, okay? Have faith in yourself. Have faith in spirit, in love. Angel of Balance. I'm just going to pull the last one. And appreciation, okay? Yeah, you're coming into something that's going to bring you balance and a new appreciation for yourself, okay? Or this is just going to happen before, you know, you decide to broaden your vision here and see what's right in front of you that maybe you've overlooked. Definitely, sorry about that. I thought I was hearing something. Ghost. So yeah, I mean, it's like you're letting this, you're battling between logic, fear-based thoughts, and it's time to listen to your heart. You're letting your insecurities, your fears get in the way of what it is you truly want, okay? And so it's like you're, when you do that, you're unable to see what is standing right in front of you. Or if something does come in that's new, you know, you're not, if you're still in that period of clouded thoughts, you're not going to be able to see the abundance that that person holds or that that new situation holds for you. Okay? So it's like Spirit's telling you, you need to believe in the magic. Embrace your transformation here, coming into your power. Embrace that. Let go of the past. Let go of your fears. You're brilliant and you're blessed. And that's definitely telling me that's what you need to do for yourself. And I think you know who this person is. I just have a feeling this could be someone like an ex that hurt you, definitely. And they're trying to come back into your life, but you're really fighting it. Like you're really sitting here. You're afraid to get hurt again. So you're pushing them out. You're pushing this like creation in reverse. You're not letting something new come of this. You're not giving it a chance. I'm sorry, that was too many. When it could lead you to a happy family, it could lead you to love, or to just a loving, stable connection in a job, whatever it is you're desiring right now, however this resonates for you. All right, let's hear it. Okay. Okay, you got the Hawk, the messenger. Spirit is sending you messages. Open your greater vision. Oh my gosh. Virgo, what did I say? Open your greater vision. It's standing right in front of you. Focus on priorities and eliminate distractions. You have a bright future. Let yourself ascend to new heights. Wow. Open your greater, that sentence alone, open your greater vision to see the signs, okay? So once you open that greater vision, once you get rid of those clouds that are covering your eyes there, I feel like it's going to be standing right in front of you. And you're going to be like, oh my gosh, how did I not see that? All this time. I'm actually going to put this one right here. Yeah, I'm going to start doing that. I like that. All right. Ooh. Well, we got two that flipped, so if I can do that. All right. Draft. Visionary. Rise above earthly matters. Glide through life with grace. You are able to see, once again, see the right path. Stand tall in your self-worth and love with a big heart. Visionary. Yeah. Open your vision. Visionary. And then it says here, open your greater vision. They both say the word see and vision because your vision is clouded right now. Wow. That lines up so perfect, Virgo. The Lynx, keeper of secrets. Take time out from the world and be the observer. Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. You see others' secrets and keep them sacred. In silence and solitude, you will find your strength. Yes. So it's like a period of going within and trust, getting in touch with your inner knowing that you've been disconnected from with the wisdom card in reverse and the discernment. It's like, I think I said this in another reading as well, because this card came out. Take time out from the world and be the observer. That makes me feel like you need to tell your brain to be quiet. And just and those thoughts, they just need to observe what's going on. They have no business telling you, you know, what to do or that you shouldn't do anything. It's like your ego. It's like, be quiet, okay? Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. So those thoughts cannot deceive you if you just trust your inner knowing, Virgo. And that'll open your vision to what it is that's standing in front of you, that's already in your life. Or, like I said, if an offer comes in, you'll be able to see what that person or whatever it is has to offer. Instead of letting your fear and clouded judgment push it away. So this is my the Wild Offering Oracle deck. And I just like to mention this when I use this deck that, you know, it says things like God and Lord. But it's based on just the divine love. So if you don't like those terms, just replace the word with spirit or whatever it is you believe in, because the messages themselves are beautiful. All right. I usually just pull one. Oh, wow. Forgiveness, Virgo. Healing comes from acceptance. Help me, dear Lord, to fully accept what is, knowing that this alone will open me to the new. Oh my gosh, Virgo, what we've been talking about, opening you up to the new, to something that's been standing right in front of you, but it's going to be absolutely new to you when you see it. You're going to be like, oh my gosh. And healing comes from acceptance. And maybe there is somebody that you need to forgive, or you need to forgive yourself, because the card says forgiveness. Just accept what is, okay? That way you can move on from it, leave it in the past. We had many cards here that said leave it in the past, I believe. And it's just, it's time to open your vision to what's standing in front of you, what the universe is trying to offer you. Okay? Don't let your ego or your fear-based thoughts get in the way of what is in your, like, really in your face right now, because I feel like it's something that you're just not seeing, and it's already there. The offer has already come in, and you're just kind of refusing it. You're not seeing clearly. So yeah, that's what's coming though. You are coming into your power, and action is going, something's coming. action is coming, okay? So something different. And I think Spirit's just trying to tell you to be open to that. Be open to seeing things in a different light. Be open to looking at things in a different perspective. Opening your vision, you know? Because Spirit's sending you messages. And it says here, open your greater vision to see the signs. The universe, I feel like, is sending you signs. And you need to open your vision to that. Okay, well, I hope this brought clarity and, you know, insight to a situation you're in or anything. Just let me know if this resonated. I would love to hear that. Okay, Virgo? All right. Thank you so much. Bye.